Hello everyone, I'm Santanu Shivare and you are watching Learn Anything. So we have covered about 20 parts of the HTML5 series, and in the previous video we just talked about what are the uses of submit button and how you can actually implement one in your own forms. Now in this video I'm gonna talk about the reset button. Okay, the video will be pretty short this time because the reset button is actually really easy to use and its work is really simple. Okay, the work of the reset button, as you can actually guess, since the name is itself a self-explanatory term, it actually resets everything that user has inputted in the form to their default values. Okay, once you press the reset button, all of the fields in the form will be erased and they will be set to their default values, okay, that you will be providing or you might have not provided. So there will be some default values that will be there and all of those fields will be set to those values. So in this video I'm just gonna tell you how you can actually create a reset button and how you can and what kind of attributes you can actually go ahead and use in that button. Okay, so let's get started with this video. So as you can see here, that this is the same file that we were working in the previous video also. Okay, we use the same file to create the submit button also. Now I'm gonna go ahead and type another one, that is another input tag. So in this input tag you will have to specify the type is equals to reset. Okay, as you can see here, this is really simple. You just have to like change the type in input and there will be a new button or new kind of input. Okay, and then rest of the stuff is actually same. You can actually go ahead and write id is equals to like say rest. And now I'm just gonna close the tag and just save it up. Okay, I'm gonna save it up. I'm gonna go to the browser. Now on refreshing it, you can actually go ahead come and see that there is a button of reset. Okay, so let's say I write anything here and I resetted it. So as you can see here, everything is now blank. There is nothing right here. So same here also, you can do this, then write anything here. Then let's say you choose this value volleyball. Okay, earlier there was baseball and now we have chose volleyball. On resetting it, as you can see here, everything comes to their default state. Okay, the bar was right here in the beginning. There was a baseball option already selected in this list. There was nothing in this list selected earlier and this field was actually empty. So reset button is actually sets all of the values to their default values. Okay, so that's the work of the reset button. Now you can actually use the value attribute to change the text on the reset button actually. So I'm gonna show you how you can do that. Okay, so value, let's say I'm gonna write this is to reset form. Okay, now guys, you can actually use the CSS style sheets on this button also. Okay, you can actually go ahead and make this button look awesome also. Okay, so as you can see here, on refreshing the browser, this is to reset form. This text is now appearing on the button. Okay, the functionality is still the same. Okay, there's nothing changed in the functionality, it still resets everything else. Okay, so guys, this is it for this video and I hope you've learned something from this video. And if you have any questions or any queries about the HTML5 or the previous project that I've created, or any you want me to create anything else also, then please feel free to comment in the comment box guys, and I will try to reach out to you as soon as possible. So and guys, if you have any code that you want me to see, okay, if there is any error that you are facing, then please try to give me the code also. Okay, put the code on the GitHub or any place like that, or in the Dropbox or Google Drive also, and then just give me the link so that I can actually go ahead and look at your code and tell you the best possible answer to my abilities. Okay, because sometimes it is really easy to solve a problem. The problem might be in the code or maybe in the syntaxes or something like that, and sometimes people are just not able to pick those things up. Okay, so looking at the code actually helps a lot. And if you have any, so this is it for this video guys, and if you think that this video was helpful, then please feel free to like, share and subscribe this channel. And till the next video guys, goodbye.